must say that this was a great surprise for me to see so many people coming from so far places like Brazil. I got some information from your teacher, and she told me that you are using low potencies mostly. Who is using high potencies from Brazil? From Brazil? Yes. You are using high potencies. Okay. Okay. So I don't know what you have heard about my teaching. Most probably you hear that I'm using high potencies, okay? This is not true. I use from very low to very high potencies, depending on the case. Very low to very high. So what I wanted to say as an introduction, that I respect whatever helps a sick person to become better, okay? Whatever. Especially if the problem is chronic, is deep, and is severe. We have problems with such cases. I don't know how much of such cases. I don't know the general health state of Brazil. But seeing the dancers, I consider them as very healthy, very healthy population. When I see these people, I say, my God, this is the this is the acme of health. Brazilians have great health. So I see also that from your response, you are not facing the problems that we face here in Europe and North America. Which the general population is so degenerated in their health that we have big problems in treating such cases. Big problems. So you are lucky, because with homeopathy, if homeopathy is spread all over Brazil, you can keep the population in a very good state of health, the general population. Here in Europe, we lost our chance. And I will explain to you more. You see, there are people who are treating with vitamins, people who are treating with minerals, okay, people who are treating with herbs. And what they called all kinds of complementary things in health market. All this products act upon the physical body. So If by chance somebody has a lack of a vitamin and you give the right vitamin, he feels better. If by chance somebody has a lack of a mineral and you give this mineral, they will feel better. So treating on the physical body is the most easy way of treating people. Okay. If somebody has a tumor, take out the tumor, feels better. The problem is when the disease is more complicated, is not so simple. It's not a lack of mineral or a lack of vitamin, but it is a much deeper problem where you have in autoimmune diseases, in neuromuscular diseases, in diseases that have been the effect of several generations that inherited, gave to the children a bad health already. So, actually, when I came into homeopathy first time in 1960, 54 years ago, I perceived that what was practiced, it was only with low potencies, low potencies. And when I investigated about the results, I found out that there was some amelioration. You see, I took these mixtures of 3, 4, 5 remedies and had an amelioration. I took this mineral and I had an amelioration, etc. So the amelioration was there, but the cure, the real cure, was not. That means you were able to keep somebody on a certain level, tolerably well, but the actual problem was never eradicated. Do I speak slowly? Is it okay?
It's okay.
It's okay.
Yes, it's okay.
Okay. So the kind of homeopathy that gives 3, 4, 5 remedies on a low potency is easy. Why it's easy? Because we have established that if somebody has headaches, the best remedies for headaches are this, and that remedies. You give all of them. Sometimes you separate in 3, 4 batches. First you give the first 10, then you give the next 10, then the third 10. Somewhere the headache is going to be modified. This is the easy homeopathy, which I understand that it is necessary because the other way, that means finding the similimum, is taking so much time, so much investigation, so much effort, and so much study before you can give the remedy. So, when you use these measures, low potencies, herbs, minerals, etc., you are treating the physical body. You are treating, you are affecting mostly the physical body. But the physical body, I mean, we as humans, we don't have only physical bodies. We have also a part of us which is not physical. It is psychological. It's emotional. Huh? And it's mental. Okay? So it is a psychosomatic remedy, psychosomatic medicine that we are dealing with. And what I have found out quite early, it was that if by chance or by study you have given the correct remedy, there was a kind of rejuvenation, a kind of explosion of the organism. It was touching the immune system in its very deepest core, and the immune system was mobilized. There was an immediate reaction, and after an initial aggravation, you had a fantastic effect, sometimes unbelievable effect. You can't, you know, the people of you have seen such cases, I'm sure, that you don't believe on the effect of the homeopathic remedy, of the correct homeopathic remedy. So here you have come to learn how can you find and can apply the correct homeopathic remedy. This is the idea. You see, those who have learned this art, this science, they become so successful that then they can have anything they like. But before you can become successful, you must be dedicated in studying and make this knowledge real your way of life. You see, homeopathy is magical, it's very attractive, because the moment that you have in front of you a patient who is suffering for years, and you have attained the art and the science to bring back health to this person who has been suffering for 10 years, 15 years. It's like a miracle. It sounds like a miracle. It's not a miracle. It's a matter of knowledge, of understanding what you are doing. The other, you can ameliorate. It's good. You do not know how to do it. But if you learn how to do it, it's a tremendous difference between amelioration and cure. Tremendous difference. It's a battle, I know. But beautiful battle. It's something that will give you back anything you can imagine. Many times, by many doctors, that I am a bad guy because I prescribe only one remedy. And they should kill me and blah, 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 and all that. And because you give only one remedy, and what is this? And there has been a lot of fights, a lot of aggressions, you know. But I always said, okay, this is correct. If you like it, you take it. If you don't like it, goodbye. What is the problem? Continue with what you want to do. I will not accuse you. Why you should attack me all the time? Later on, I went to India. In 63, I went back to India. I went to India to different colleges where they were teaching homeopathy. All the colleges were teaching pluralist homeopathy, low potencies with mixtures of remedies, all of them. I went to different colleges to see if I could learn something. It was not. You see, I went to America in 1970. I said, how many homeopaths are in the United States today? There were 3 medical doctors and about 10 people, lay people. That's all. Homeopathy was diluted, it was finished. Today, there is a big movement, and I can tell you that at this moment, 5 medical schools are adapting homeopathy for their medical doctors. And the numbers are increasing fast. How this came about? When I was teaching in Europe, I told them that we should do something for homeopathy, to promote homeopathy, and especially to the medical schools. And they said, you are crazy. Never medical schools will accept your teaching. Okay. 25 years later. Of course, I lived long enough to do this. That is true. Otherwise, I should, you know, if I had ever used allopathic drugs for my health, I would be dead long time ago. But I never in my life took allopathic drugs for anything. Never, not one time. Only one dose when I was 16 years old, I took one anti-inflammatory drug because I had severe pains in my back and my stomach was burning for 2 days. That was the last. One dose of anti-inflammatory drug at the age of 16. But nothing more. So what you are going to learn here is a little bit difficult. It's a bit difficult. And I will try to show you with cases, real cases. Either alive, there are some people who have asked me to take their cases, so you will observe the taking of the case. But I have to tell you a few things of how I take the case. You see, in medicine, they teach you how to recognize a case of bronchitis, to differentiate it from a case of pneumonia, to differentiate it from a case of pharyngitis, etc. How can you recognize a gastritis from a duodenal ulcer? How a spastic colitis is, and what is the difference with ulcerative colitis? And once you establish this, you give the remedy, okay? The way that a homeopath takes a case now, this information is a little part of what you need. The information of the pathology which he has, the diagnosis, it's a little part. What you are interested? You are interested on the whole of the human being, how he behaves. How is that behaves when he comes back home and he's tired and his wife starts telling him blah, 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 why you're late, blah, 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 blah. And then he explodes and cannot control himself and he throws things, this is bad. And you realize that this man who had the gastritis is a case of nux vomica. It's not a case of robinia, which also is a severe, severe gastritis symptoms, because he cannot control himself. And then a woman comes and she says, before my menses, I become a monster. Don't let anybody talk to me before my menses. 2 days before my menses, I will kill anybody who will come in front of me. Okay, what else? There is also a chronic constipation. Constipation, what type of constipation? With urging but no effect. Just this little information is very important. Why? Why it's important? Because you know the materia medica. That is why you can differentiate between one remedy and the other. So therefore, when you take the case, as the information comes in the back of your mind, there is the information that you have on the different pictures of materia medica. So you always compare the information with what you know from the materia medica. And then you differentiate. And then the case goes towards nux vomica, because she's such a bitch. You understand the word bitch? It did not translate properly. If she does not, she makes modifications. I need the similimum. Exactly. Not modifications. Not low potencies. Okay. So the taking of the case, you will see my taking of the case. You see, okay, this woman says that she's so irritated and so irritable. She speaks so badly to her husband, and she has a constipation, but the constipation is not like urging without effect, because nax vomica is a nervous remedy, very nervous. The nervous system is at edge. So the whole nervous system is becoming irritated. So, but nax vomica has kept inside quite a lot of anger. She did not, she had a fight, and she did not bring out all the anger that was inside her. She was controlling. So the nervous system kept the anger, the irritation. So this irritation appears on the peripheral nervous system as a spasm on the rectum, a spasm in the rectum. Gives the idea that wants to have a stool, goes there to the toilet, no stool, goes back, goes, stool does not come out, anger cannot come out. Okay, this is the typical constipation of nax vomica. But you investigate the case and you see that she has a constipation, but no urging at all. No urging. If there is no urging, then you have to think twice before you go to nax vomica. Okay? So you investigate further some other remedy. Which other remedy? Which can be? In order to find out, for instance, eventually, that this woman is a religious person who is all the time under a state of irritation, but also dissatisfaction on the sexual level. So becomes irritable, bitchy, she will say bad words, she will fly into a temper, she will go from one room to the other, shutting the doors, saying bad words to her husband, etc. And then you investigate about the sexual sphere. How is your sexual life? Oh, you know, not so good. You know, sometimes women talk more easily about their sexual life than men. When you ask men about their sexual life, usually says normal. Normal. All men, normal. Unless there is a total incapacity of erection and he has come for this, all the others, normal. Okay. But the women, they talk because they are not so shy. I don't know Brazilians, maybe the Brazilians are more shy. But the... No. But you see, with the sexual freedom that has prevailed in our countries, especially Europe, North America. Freedom. So, women, they have no problem talking about their sexual deviations, whatever. I remember teaching in Berkeley, in California, and the class was here, and I was teaching in a place not like this, about 20 meters away, where I was taking the case, and by TV, the students, they were listening. And I remember a case, an American young girl, she was telling such extreme things concerning her sexual life that the class that was 20 meters away or 50 meters away or totally in a big, I could hear them laughing. Ah, the whole class was laughing. I said, I go to the class. I said, why you were laughing so loud? They said, because we felt that you were going to have a cultural shock with what you are listening from here. I said, yes. I had a cultural shock, of course. But so freely to say all these things without any shame, anything. It was for me. I was, you know, I'm talking about 80, about 30 years ago. It was 55, simply, you know, okay. But still, I could not believe the freedom. This kind, I don't know if you have it in Brazil, so open. But anyhow, Brazil is a race which is very loving, a lot of emotions. Brazil, a lot of emotions. Now it's not. But I will tell you something, that if you have an emotional person, if you have a person as a patient who has strong emotions, you will have an easy case. If you have a person who is closed and the emotions are burnt out, forget it. You will battle to get some information. You will get yes, no, yes, no. I said, just describe a little bit the situation. But if you have an emotional person, like you have, I can see your emotions are floating, you know, and no problem. You will have easy cases for what we are going to teach you. So, what you will have to observe during the taking of the case, you will have to observe the questions, because the questions I put indicate what I have in my mind as a possibility at the moment. Every question, there is a meaning. And behind each question, there is a possibility of a remedy. Those now who have the information, who have attended quite a lot, the full course, what we call the full course of homeopathy, they can follow. And they know George now investigating the possibility of platina. George now investigating the possibility of Medorinum, George now investigating the possibility of Calcarea carbonica. So they understand. Sometimes they don't understand because it goes to a small remedy. The case goes to a very small remedy. Paris quadrifolia. Some cases like that. Who knows Paris quadrifolia? No. Yeah. Says you have to attend the classes to know the Paris quadrifolia. But this time, the first time that a case of Paris quadrifolia appears in the class, nobody knows. Nobody. It's okay. But most of the cases are. Most of the cases are understood, followed by the students who have taken the full course. I will tell you something. I'll tell you something to see how we are thinking and how we are observing. Okay. In 1969, I was back in Greece, and I had one student, a medical doctor, a neurologist, Irini. And we were thinking together how to promote homeopathy in Greece, okay? And she said, I had a teacher in university whom I know quite well, so I will invite him in my home, and you also come, and by chance, we start talking. He was a professor of medicine, cardiology, in a university medical school. So we come, by chance, we start talking about homeopathy, and he gets interested, and in the end, after 2 hours of discussion, he says, okay, I'm a practical man, so I have a coryza, I have a cold, and I know the cold is going down tomorrow, and then I have bronchitis, usually, this is the usual course. Can you stop it? Can you give me a remedy to stop my coryza, to stop my cold? I said, yes. Why? I had taken a full case while we were talking. 2 hours. First of all, it was winter, of course. The house was a little bit cold. But he stayed with his overcoat all the time. You understand overcoat? The heavy, yeah. All the time he was with this. I was with my pullover, he was with overcoat. Big overcoat, thick. And then from time to time, he will get up from this chair and he will go and sit on another chair. And he will get up from this chair and he will go to another chair. And then I noticed his nose was red because of the acid discharge. It was right, his nose. So without asking any question about this to him, the remedy was arsenicum album, restlessness, cold, feeling very cold, acid discharge. You do not need more than this. I said to Irini, bring him one dose of arsenicum 200. He did not hear the remedy because arsenicum is, they are going to kill me now. I said to Irini, arsenicum 200.
Okay, give it to him. So he took, he greets me, thank you, bye-bye. He had my telephone number. Oh yes, I told him, because the coffin has started. So he had some discharge and coffin. I said, next day, most probably, you have no coffin, but the discharge will be more, much more. Okay, bye-bye. Next day, he calls me. He says, Professor blah, 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 discharge is more, no coffin. Pop! Close the telephone. Okay. Next day, he says, the professor, so, no discharge. Close the telephone. He said, okay. So after that, he calls me one day, he says, I have a case like this. And he described to me a case of severe acne with thick discharges and the very bad situation. Can you do anything for this? I said, yes, give one dose of Calcarea Sulfurica 200. Close the telephone. Very professional. 15 or 20 days later, he calls me. He says, do you remember the girl with the acne, severe acne? Yes, I kissed her. I said, what do you mean? He says, her skin is totally normal. So I kissed her. And of course, he became my student later on, and we started. This is the type of effect you are going to have. This is how homeopathy was spread all over the world because, only because of the effect that this kind of homeopathy has. Yes, there is homeopathy, easy homeopathy. There are ghost homeopathy. There are all kinds of homeopathy, you name it. You know, some people, they say, I found the cure for AIDS. You know what it is? He says, I will send you a disc with a song. You play the song, and if you play the song for a month, you are cured. You are cured from AIDS. He says, my God, do you call this homeopathy? He says, yes, because the vibrations of this song is telling with the vibrations of AIDS. And then it's similia similibus curantur. I said, similia similibus, you are crazy. I mean, another one, he says, I will send you the remedy through your mobile. How? You see, he plays he sent some vibrations on the mobile, now you received your remedy. Another one says, you don't have to give the remedy, you have a piece of paper like this, right here, like a podium, 10 m. Take the water, put it over it, and then you drink it. And then you took like a podium, 10 m. I mean, all this is called homeopathy, all this. Then another one says, you don't you look like animal. Which animal? All, take all. You look like, you look, if the person looks like an animal, you give animal remedy. If looks like a vegetable, give vegetable remedy. If he looks like mineral, give mineral remedy. I said, okay. I had the class here, a full house. And I presented a case of asthma. A German man with mustaches, big mustaches, black hair, he was looking like. I said to the class, he looks like a vegetable, an animal, or a mineral. Animal, all the class. I said, very good. Now I will show you the remedy that cure. I said to this, put the video, and this man was cured with belladonna. Belladonna. I said, what is this nonsense? I mean, they call it, before you understand where you are, a lot of people have given you all kinds of ideas and nonsense. Another one says, you don't even have to make a proving. You just imagine what the proving could do. What the proving could do? Can you imagine? So if I tell you, I have a remedy, okay, I'll tell you the remedy, is I have a remedy which is a plant, and it is called agave. Please imagine what this remedy can do. Each one of you, you will imagine a different thing, of course. Is this homeopathy? I said to them, but this is not homeopathy. This is your craziness. You are crazy, but keep it to yourself. Don't spread the craziness. Because everybody, if everybody becomes crazy, then we have a problem. This doctor, he's a medical doctor, he came here, he says, I would like your blessings. I said, you are crazy, and you want me to bless you? You spread your craziness. Are you serious? Wow. Doesn't matter. He said, I'm sorry, but you tell the people that you are telling lies. You confess your sins. Tell everybody, I was bluffing you. I was telling stories in order to bluff you. Okay. Who is? I hear a voice from a man, but I look there and all girls are there. How is possible? There is a man. Oh, there is a man. And now I solved the problem. I said to myself, I hear a voice. Another man is there. Another man is there. Oh, you are blind. Oh, but he does not talk. He's quiet. He's quiet. The other one talks. The other one, who's behind. Yes, yes. I could not believe that. Who is this woman with such voice? You know, all the time, I said to myself, what? So, go back to the way I take the case. Usually, they teach you that you have to let the patient talk and tell you everything. And I don't allow, and you don't let patients to talk and tell me everything. I interrupt them and I ask questions. And I told you why I ask questions, because in my mind I get four symptoms and I form an idea about the remedy, okay? And this is considered as a bad way of taking the case, because you may miss some information in this way. You may miss some information that the patient would have given you in case you did not interrupt. That is true. But at the same time, I have to take a case within a certain period of time. And I have to come here from the case-taking room. I have to come back and make the analysis and explain to you why I put these questions, what is the remedy, support this idea of the remedy, etc. So therefore, I do not have unlimited time. You see, sometimes you will be, I know you will be angry because you don't follow the process. And you will say, what is this? And sometimes you will shout. I remember a case. I was taking the case inside. It's a woman. It's a medical person. She had problems with her mother, a great conflict with her mother. So she started talking about her mother. And I went to our country house, and there I had my mother, and my mother did not greet me. I said this to my mother said, Dad, blah, blah. And then another day this happened, blah, blah, blah. And then this happened, blah, 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 blah. I let her talk for a while. I understand there's a big conflict between, and suddenly, because I put some questions, did not pay attention. She continued with the story, to tell the story. So I said, please, I will ask questions and you answer only the question. I was very abrupt. You understand, abrupt. Abrupt. So she stopped and she answered questions. Then I come inside. There was a German group. That was Germans, all Germans. So I start analyzing the case. And one German woman gets up and she says to me, but George, I don't understand you. You are so patient in other times. And now you spoke so badly to this poor woman. Blah, 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 she accused me. And then another one gets up, says, I also agree with I say, okay, you take causticum, and you take causticum. And the lady here, she also needs causticum, so causticum 50 mg. So they were surprised. I said, okay, okay. The woman says, 50 mg, I cannot take 50 mg. I said, 50 mg, okay. If you don't like 50 mg, take whatever you like. So 6 months later, the group comes back. I said, tell me how you are. I'm much better and everything. He said, you remember, did you take your causticum? Causticum. Causticum is a remedy that cannot tolerate injustice. They felt I was treating her with injustice. So they could not tolerate, they had to get up, and they respected me very much. You know, all my students, they respect me, they love me, but also I feel they must be free to tell whatever they like, okay? Otherwise, it will be like suppressing you. So they cannot withstand to keep it inside the anger when some injustice is seen. The causticum will get up and speak, or sometimes was one woman, she was quite short. I said, what are you going to do if you see injustice, especially treating animals? Causticum have a special sensitivity to seeing people treating badly animals. She said, I attack one man, a huge man, I attack him and hit him because he was treating his dog badly. She was like this. Causticum is of that type. So therefore, what we are interested in taking the case, we are interested to know the psychosomatic, the psychology, the mental emotional picture, together with the pathology. Not only the pathology, okay, the pathology is one, but what about the whole person, how he behaves emotionally, especially? You see, I will tell you something maybe you do not know. Do you know when you are going to be attentive to what I say? When you are emotionally open, and when I put emotion in my sayings, then it becomes alive. Otherwise, I mean, who can stay 1.5 hours? Go to any lecture, 1.5 hours, to keep alive and not to go like this. I mean, it's not possible. It's not possible unless there is emotionality in this speaking. So in order to communicate, we don't communicate with ideas. We communicate with emotion. And then the idea comes. If I come here and I give you ideas, you may attend half an hour, 35 minutes, 36 minutes, 37 minutes. You come back, you see, sometimes you will see in the class this happening. This is 37, 40 minutes. You say, oh my God, what have I done? You see, it's terrible. It's terrible. The moment the teacher is tired, especially, that means there is no emotional energy, the class goes down. Usually the cases that I see are very complicated, are the most difficult, because they come from very far, to the island to be treated. They're desperate. Okay, all of cases. These cases are not going to be cured with one remedy. These cases, they have different layers of remedies that the homeopath has to recognize which is the right one first, the right one second, the right one third, the right one fourth, and then you may have the effect. You understand? Why is not difficult? Why, I said, for you maybe it's not so difficult because you don't have so many deep chronic conditions. I don't know. As I said, I'm looking on the girls that dance and I get an impression. Girls are very healthy. Very, very, too healthy. So, therefore, you will have the experience of taking a case. I must say also that somebody, he wrote me about his case, and I refused. I said, don't let him come, this case. I cannot promise that this case will be cured. But as he came, then I will take his case. Thank you.